And now, as somewhere in Lagos, Theophilus is standing by. Good morning, Theophilus.
All right, Kemi, Mike, and Uncle Sam, now the newspaper. We are here at the newspaper stand in Ilele in Keto Axis this morning. And of course, a lot of people are reacting to the headlines this morning. Of course, we'll look at the several newspapers here. We'll look at the New Telegraph newspaper. It says here, elites behind oil theft, illegal refineries in Niger Delta. That's according to Shell. Elites behind oil theft, illegal refineries in the Niger Delta. That's according to the Shell. We'll move to the Nation newspaper this morning. It talks about Yoruba elders to Tinubu, your victory in 2023 certain. Yoruba elders to Tinubu, your victory in 2023 certain. That's in the Nation newspaper. We move to the Punch newspaper this morning. It talks about Wike saying that peace talks suffer. Wike dissents on Atiku's men. Peace talks suffer. Wike dissents on Atiku's men. All right, so we'll look at the Guardian newspaper. It says here, Wike Atiku camps return to trenches. Wike Atiku camps return to trenches. That's in the Guardian newspaper this morning. So the last but not the least, This Day newspaper. NUPRC stands firm on mobile satellites, no deal, insist status quo remains. This Day newspaper this morning. All right, so one more newspaper at this point, the Vanguard newspaper. Man LCCI to federal government, rising death-threatening economy. Man LCCI to federal government, rising death-threatening economy. That's in the Vanguard newspaper this morning. So let's take reactions from Nigerians on the newspaper stands this morning. Several reactions before we went on air. And of course, it's been an interesting conversation here. Let me start with you this morning. Looking at the newspapers now, what's your take on all of this?
Good morning, Theophilus, and good morning, Nigerians. Yeah, Nigerians are in the era of election this time around. My take on the newspapers is that of the forthcoming election, 2023. To me, I would say it is high time for Nigerians to come out in mass and vote, and a vote eligible candidate who has what it takes to govern Nigeria. Nigeria has been facing serious of issues. We talk about the challenges of the security challenges in Nigeria. It's getting rampant, it's getting increasing and getting worse in every day. Nigerians will not continue like this, because if we should continue like this, Nigeria will be sinking day and day. That is why we say that the total Nigerians should come out with their PVCs to vote for a candidate whom they believe that will bring us out of this mess, because I call it a mess. We are in a mess because we have leaders who are supposed to be there to represent us in our various own constituencies. We have senators, we have House of Rep members who are supposed to be doing what we send them there to do, but are they doing what we ask them to do for us? So that is why we said we should all come out in mass and vote for a rightful candidate. Do not sell your vote. The man you believe that has what it takes should be the one you should vote for, so that Nigeria will be good and better for us. If Nigeria is good, it will be good for me and good for you. That is my take on the newspapers.
All right, so let's take another reaction. Your reaction, sir.
Well, to me, we thank God for what God has done to Nigeria. But to me, as the country is going now, it is very, very perspective in terms of security. The security is getting worse every time, every day. But we believe if you can have a good leader, a leader that can at least change the narrative, change the system, change, for example, now, we need a restructure. You know, to me, I will advise Nigerians, any presidential candidate that believes in restructuring, I believe that person is going to win the election. So that is my comment.
Okay. All right, let's have more reactions to the news this morning. So what's your own take on the headlines this morning?
I did not go through the headline, but what I know about, I'm talking about the election process of it.
Okay.
One, the politics, the leader, they will promise us when they get there, they will do something for the youth. But at the end of it, we did not see anything. Okay, now I want to pick two things. Now they are threatening us with no bike again, nothing. But at the same time, people are bringing money out to vote, to go for this ticket for 100 and something. Rasu is there now for more than 8 years now. Nothing happened. So again, you can't walk outside there. Policeman will accuse you of being dressing normal. One. Two, three again, what we need now, they should give us the right thing they have for the youth.
Okay, what would that be?
Our own rights.
In your own opinion, what will be your own right? What do you want?
What we need, like this Rasu of 18, they should give us our, is the Rasu 30-something minimum wage is not too big. From the money that one person will carry more than 70 billion, at the end of it, we pay 1.5 to kill. So they should let the youth to have freedom of their own.
Okay.
Like all I'm right. saying now, I don't have work. More than 8 years now. So I've been trying to sell market, but at the same time, Agbero will come and tear tickets. Okay, this ticket for Hawking. At the same time, again, they will still arrest us. So what do they want us to do? If they continue like this, if I see offer of 5,000 naira, I will do it. I don't want to know whether it's Tokyo or to, I will do it.
You will not do that.
I'm frustrated now.
We understand. Don't worry. Let's have your reaction. Please come.
I'm not saying because I want to.
Good morning, Nigerians. I'm Olariwa Julekon by name. My reaction on this morning paper goes to that of Yoruba elders to Tinubu. And to me, as a person, it's a right decision in the right direction. And if you look at it concerning the candidates we have for presidency, I believe the man is one of the strong politicians that can make this country a better place for us. There are things many people talk about him, but I believe nobody is a saint. Even I myself am not a saint. I also believe Tinubu is not a saint. I know, I believe strongly, at least 35%, he will try his best out of 100. I believe that because the country is messed up already, and we need a politician, a strong politician, that we break all this yoke we have concerning Nigeria, because we are one of the greatest country in the whole of, if I'm not going to use war, but in Africa. But why are we always at the back? Many times we always beg for help. Why do we beg for help? As in Nigeria, with all what we have human power, we have resources, we have, some countries don't have water. We have two types of water. We have sea, we have river. Despite that, we have all the mineral resources that man can use to become a man, let alone a country. Still, we're still in this situation. So we need somebody, a strong politician, that will break all the yoke that is battling Nigeria. So with what Yoruba elders said this morning, I totally in support of that. Let's support this man so that I can, at least 35%, he will do this country better, a place for us.
All right, that's it on the newspaper stand this morning. Diverse reactions, diverse views to the headlines on the front pages of the newspapers this morning. Now over to the studio.